वेलकम टू टॉप क्रू एविएशन, दिस इज कैप्टन पी के यादव। नाउ गाइस, वी वुड डिस्कस व्हाट आर द प्रोहिबिटेड एरियाज, व्हाट आर द रिस्ट्रिक्टेड एरियाज एंड व्हाट आर द डेंजर एरियाज एंड हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट देम ऑन चार्ट्स एंड हाउ वी कैन identify, because on charts you would find that it is already represented, but we should know both the things, how to represent them on charts and how to identify them on charts, guys. Now we would discuss how we can identify these kind of areas on the charts, guys. Okay, now we would look what are these kind of areas in chart number one. So let's have a look, guys. Look at over here. I'll tell you. Look at over here, guys. This is VIR 156. So how do we represent them? So it would be a triangle or in any other shape, guys, with the red color boundary. Okay, and VI means belongs to Delhi. VIR 156 means restricted area of Delhi, guys. Let's have a look for the other one. Look at over here, guys. VIR 41. So this is the restricted area of Delhi. Restricted area of Delhi number 41. Same goes to restricted area of Delhi 37, guys. Let's try to find out some more. Let's see. Hold on, guys. We can do like this. Like this is the restricted area. This one too. Just hold on, guys. Yes. So more or less, not going here and there. As for the screen, we can see this is the restricted area. This is the restricted area, and this is the restricted area. So guys, if it is, see, if there is a like, if it is VIR. If it is R, then restricted area. If it is P, means prohibited area. If it is D, means danger areas, guys. That can be in any chart. We will have a look. So this is how we can identify, and we would come to know which area we have to avoid, or in case we have entered in it in practical flying. Okay, guys. All right, guys. So this was about chart number one. Let me try to hold on. Let's see if we do have other restriction, any area. Like, look at over here. If you see in this, let me look at over here, guys. This is with the red color boundary. Alright, so this is your VAR. Alright, so this is in Mumbai, guys. So do remember, restricted area of Mumbai number 34. Okay, so this is how we would identify. This is how we come to know about restricted areas, danger areas and prohibited areas in charts, guys. Okay, so this was it in chart number one. Now let's have a look in other charts too. Okay, so now we can have a look, guys. This is chart number two. Okay, in chart number two, if we try to find out, we do see over here, guys. Look at over here. We do see this as the restricted area of Delhi 135. Okay, so this is about chart number two. Now let's talk about other charts too. Okay, so let me have a look. Okay, chart number three, do we have any? Yes, we can have a look, guys. So in chart number three, hold on, guys. So guys, let's have a look about these areas in chart number three. So this is the chart number three, guys, for your convenience, and I hope now you can identify them, guys. So for you, like, let me identify, otherwise I would have asked it for me. Okay, so look at over here, guys. This is your VID 126, means VI is Delhi, guys. So D is danger. So do not make mistakes. This is not for Delhi guys. This is for danger area of Delhi 126. Next, we can see, like, look at over here. Like, this is your restricted area of Delhi. So we do have danger, we do have restricted. If it is P, it means that is prohibited as we discussed earlier. Let's have a look other than this two. Just hold on guys. Okay. So we do have one more area. This is also restricted guys. So this is the restricted area. Restricted area of Delhi 151. So it is about chart number 3. Now guys, we would discuss about the same thing about danger, prohibited and restricted area on chart number 7, because it is important for you, and most of you make this mistakes in part 2. So first of all, we would cover about part 1. Look at over here guys, this is your VOR, this is your VOR 175. So VO means Chennai guys, as for the FIR, we have already discussed about it in details. If you still do not know what does it mean, VI, VE, VO, and then guys, go ahead and you know, watch the previous video related to the FIR, and you may get it on I button too. I'll give the link above, okay, so that you will come to know about it in details. So guys, what happens, this is your chart number 7, and in this there is a VOR, restricted area of Chennai 175. So guys, but in part 2 they may ask you what is VOR 175. If you are not aware about this, you are going to tell them the full form of VOR guys. So this is not that VOR. You need to tell them about full form. This is your restricted area of Chennai 175. Do remember that. That's why I'm mentioning over here, okay? And one more thing I would like to tell you about this chart. This is your chart number 7, where UTA, upper area control limit, is applicable guys. It is not written in this chart, but I'm telling you, on this particular chart, UTA is upper area control limit is from flight level 255 to flight level 2460. So above flight level 255 in complete chart, wherever you are flying from, wherever, whatever is the destination, whatever is your aerodrome, above flight level 255, you would use Chennai control only guys. Do remember about it. You would use Chennai control only. Okay, so upper area control limit in this chart only, in chart number 7. In case, let's say over here, if you see in Pune, alright, there is a VOR, but there is no dotted circle. If there is no dotted circle, guys, we would assume that there is a 5 nautical miles vicinity. Okay, so do remember guys, we would keep discussing about these small things on charts. And those are something different, not normal, while we would be doing exercises. Alright guys, this upper area control limit is not mentioned in chart number 7. This is this chart is old one. We would share the new charts. And nowadays guys, you know, distances, the DME distances are also mentioned on the charts. If you are going to attempt the exam, so do not get confused. These are the old charts. Now WPC is using new charts, and these charts are very much different from these charts. They have updated something, as I told you about chart number 7. And while you would be getting these charts when you are going to appear for part 1, you will get DME alright on all the charts from chart number 1 to 8. So do not get confused, that's alright. They may ask you about DME from point A to point B. So we simply just need to add them. We would exercise this while we would be making transmission calls. Alright guys, so this is all about, these are the basics about charts. Now I hope you have understood in a proper manner what are the charts and how do we use them, what are the vertical separation, how do we use while transmission, how do we identify VOR, NGV, solid triangles, what are solid triangles, and how do we call them, you know, Tiger and others. And now we do know how do we identify prohibited, restricted and danger area. We know the vertical separation, so we know almost everything about charts. Now we would practice about charts, okay, just to get more hang on charts. So I hope you enjoyed this lecture, guys. If you like this lecture, if you are liking the way I'm teaching, and if you really like it, I would request you to kindly subscribe and share this with your friends so that maximum people get benefited with these lectures. All right, guys, take care. See you soon.
Here you go, your checklist. Like, subscribe, and share.
Thank you for watching.